Hello everyone, in this video let's have a look at the Crdroid version 8.5 ROM for the LG V30. As you can see here, it is based out of Android version 12 and it also has the latest Android security patch level as of now. So let's get started. Here is the launcher, as you can see, and let's go into the settings. You will find some options for customizing the icon size, font size, and enabling or disabling the notification dots. And you can also change the icon pack from here, but I have only one icon pack installed, so can't really change that. Let's go back. Here are some home screen settings, like you can lock the layout, double tap to sleep. And since I do not have Google app installed, this interface option for Google app is disabled, and also the Google search bar as well. So let's go back and let's go in. And here is the app drawer settings. You can show icon labels on the drawer. And here are some miscellaneous options, like you can use the taskbar for switching and opening between apps, but that really takes up a lot of screen real estate at the bottom, so I disable that. And you can also allow for home screen rotation and enable hidden and protected apps as well. And you could also have some suggestions here, but I would rather just disable that on the home screen, but in the app list that is fine. So here are the reasons. As you can see here, the layout has changed a bit. And another note on that, you can basically go in, and this is the error you will be greeted with when you turn on the phone, but you can just ignore that. It's not really a big deal and it won't really affect your usage of this ROM in any way. So let's go back and let's see what other stuff we have. And under wallpaper and style, you will find some customization options, like you can enable these themed icons, and you can also change the app grid from here like this. So this is how it will be changed, but I like 5x5, so I'll just leave it on. And here is how the icon packs have changed up now. And let's go in. Here are the quick settings, as you can see here. Do know that half attack does work on this ROM, and you can find a quick tile for that here. Let's go down and try to find that one. So here are some options, like extra dim, ambient display, AOD, heads up. So there are a lot of quick tiles here as well. CPU info, smart pixels as well. And here is the quick half attack option. So let me go in and open that. But since we do not have earphones plugged in, so these options are grayed out, but it is here and it does work. Let's go into the settings now. And this is where you'll find the settings. Let me just quickly show you the normal settings. So basically you have some touchscreen gestures, like you can use these gestures while the screen is off to perform certain tasks like this, like raise the media volume, change the music, that kind of stuff. Let's go back. You can quickly open the camera as well. And here are the gesture navigation settings. As you can see here, you can disable the navigation hint at the bottom, or you can change up the pill length at the bottom. And you can also customize the length of the height that is used on the sides for the back gesture, as you can see here. And you can also change the sensitivity. Let's go back. You have 2-button navigation option and a 3-button navigation option as well, if you are into that, but I'll just disable it because I like the gesture navigations better. And you also have the option for one-handed mode, so basically you can pull it down like this. And you also have a shortcut for this, as you can see here, but I disable that because I don't really use this feature much, and since it is floating around, it would get annoying. And you can press and hold the power key for certain actions, and you can prevent ringing on vibrate. Let's go back. And here are the main Crdroid settings, but let's just hold off on that for a moment and go into the display section, because this is where you'll find the always on display hidden away. And as you can see, this ROM also supports face unlock, and you can find that in the security section, but you can allow it as well. And here is the always on display. Basically, if you click on this, it will always show the always on display. Let's go back. And this is the live display section. You have the editing mode here as well, and you can change the color calibration, and you have certain options for picture adjustment, color profile as well, as you can see. And you can enhance the colors. So let's go back. So there are a lot of customizations here, you have the option for night light, as you can see, and you can also customize that. You have double tap to wake, double tap to sleep here, or wake on plug. And this is the most feature-rich room that you will find. So let's jump in quickly and have a look at these settings. As you can see here, you can hide the status bar icons. I'll be quick here because there are a lot of settings to go through. You have the clock style, you can change where it appears, and you also have the network location monitor, up and down, download, auto hide, increase threshold activity. You can change the traffic management units, measurement units. You can hide the arrows, and you can also choose to show the clock here, AM PM style, and also the date and the date format. I do know that I'm going quickly here because you can just pause and have a look at a particular setting which interests you, but if I take too long, you'll get annoyed because the video would be too long. So you can switch up the signal icons, use 4G instead of LTE, and here is the VoLTE icon, but it is basically useless because VoLTE and v8.5 does not work on USB ROMs for LG phones, and it will never really work. And here are the privacy indicators. So they are pretty handy because they show you when an app is using either your mic, camera, or location, and I use that. You can also enable this notification count and also say use proper icons for notification icons in the status bar. You can have a battery percentage and also change how your battery indicator looks. You can enable the battery bar. As you can see here, there are a lot of options. You have different colors for low battery, full battery, or good battery life. Basically, as you can see here, it changed to an ugly color. Let me make it red. So as you can see, it is present on the top. Let's go back. You can double tap to sleep. You can control the brightness by sliding across the status bar. You also have the option for quick pull down. So basically, if you pull down on the right, you'll jump right into the quick settings, but if you swipe from the left, you'll only open the notification area. You can enable smart pull down. So basically, when there are no notifications, it will directly go into the quick settings. And if you select no dismissible notification, then it will go in if there is a non-dismissible notification. Like I have this recording notification, it cannot be dismissed, but still it goes to the quick settings. Here are the clock settings, date, in the basically quick settings place. You can have a battery estimate. You can show set to always show this brightness slider. As you can see here, it is now shown even without the quick tiles. You can adjust the position and that kind of stuff. You have footer stuff, you have running services icon, you have click notification button, clear all notification button icon here. Let's go into the lock screen. You have media, cover art, battery info. This will basically show the charge rate. You have also option for forcing a small clock. If you don't like the big one, you have double tap to sleep, fingerprint authentication, vibration can be disabled or enabled, and the same can be done for the error as well. And you can allow accessing the power menu on secure lock screen. You have navigation bar options, pixel animation for 2 or 3 button navigation bar, but I'm not using that one. And you can also show the arrow keys to use it as a cursor while typing on the keyboard. And you have options like long press to do certain tasks, like spread the screen, kill the app. So these are mainly for the navigation bar with 3 touch buttons or the 2 button navigation bar. You have power menu customization. As you can see here, you can customize here. Let me quickly show you the power menu, and it can be accessed from here. As you can see, we have a lot of options now, and you can change that. You can also enable advanced restart from here. It always comes in handy. And you can end call, you can long press for torch, you can wake the device, sense a call, control playback, that kind of stuff. And under user display, user interface section, you can wake the screen for notification. You can also enable edge lighting. So basically, this will light up the edges of your screen whenever there's a new notification. Let's go back. You can turn on smart pixels to save the battery. So this will basically disable a certain percentage of pixels to save battery and also prevent burn-in that happens on OLED displays, but it will deteriorate the quality of the content. So you have CRT and scale animation for screen off. You have certain mono engine settings as well, so you can select a custom color here. And let's see, so if I select red, as you can see it became kind of red. So you know, you can change it to anything and it will change up, as you can see here. And you have navbar style options, so basically there are a lot of options here if you are using three button gestures, but I'm not. And here you can easily change up the font of your screen. So let me see, let's select so a weird one, I guess. So as you can see here, it has become really weird, but let me change it back in case you end up not understanding what is going on in the screen, something that is more understandable. And you have certain icon pack options. You can change how your icon pack looks. Let's change it up to something that is easily noticeable. And as you can see here, I have changed it up. Let's see something else as well. And as you can see here, it has changed. Let's go back. And you have certain icon options like Wi-Fi icon style, signal icon style, so you can basically change it up. You have certain icon shape options as well. Let me set it to the heart, and heart reminds me, do click on like button for this particular video. And let me just quickly go and change in the clock style, because otherwise you may not be able to see all the options here. As you can see here, it had become quite cluttered. So where were we? Okay, so we were on this user interface. This is where I showed you all the stuff, and this is the stuff that you can do under the button section. As you can see here, pretty understandable stuff, nothing in depth. And let me show you the icons. As you can see here, the icons have changed to heart style, and you have reticker. You can basically replace the heads up notification. Heads up, you can make it less boring, that kind of stuff. And you can also blink flashlight for incoming calls to make it more noticeable, especially when your phone is on silent. And you have some other stuff like sound. You can pulse the navigation bar, so this is basically more noticeable only for the three button layout. And you can change the volume steps, so basically when you're listening to music, having more steps helps me generally to customize just to get the right amount of sound that I want. So we have the volume panel on the left now, as you can see here, and this is how it looks. So it's pretty dope. You can vibrate the call on connect, call waiting, or disconnect, so that you know without looking at the screen. You can unlock higher FPS in games like PUBG by spoofing your device as a different model. You have game space options as well. As you can see here, you have game list, notification overlay, that kind of stuff, so that you are not disturbed while you are gaming. You can turn off the ringing as well. So let's go back. You have unlimited Google Pixel photo storage mod, and you can swipe for screenshot, and you can also block the screen and button inputs when screen is in the pocket, so it does not misbehave in your pocket. So overall, my impression of this room have been really great. The battery life is good. I'm getting 5+ hours of screen on time, and the performance is really, really smooth. I'm loving this room. There is a lot of customization option, and I would definitely recommend this room for anyone looking for a lot of customization options. But do note that this does not come with Google Apps pre-installed. I'm using the one linked in the description below, that is NickG Apps, but you can use any of them if you are using the correct version for Android 12. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos.